In this video, we'll take a look at how Skaarhoj RCPs can work with Panasonic box cameras. And we have a UB300. It's the 4K box camera that fits a broadcast lens. The RCPv2 will work with this camera because it is Ethernet enabled. And it's protocol-wise a little bit like Panasonic PDC cameras, which is why we actually run the PDC device core for Panasonic cameras on this RCP. So the real takeaway here is you need an RCP for this camera in professional broadcast applications. And I'm not sure it exists, actually. Or maybe you have a converter to something else. But anyway, Skaarhoj RCPs are so flexible. You can configure them to work with robotic cameras and studio cameras and small field cameras, etc. This RCP is set up so that it works with this. You can see the picture from the camera. And most importantly, we have the RCP joystick to adjust the iris of the lens. As you can see, this works quite nicely. If we pull it all the way down, we can also expose it all the way up here. You see changes to the display where you can see the iris level. We can adjust the master black with the ring, which is a classic operation of an RCP joystick. We have the way we traditionally set up our RCPs, we also have the pedestal shown right here in this display. So we could also do it with the encoder knob here. And sometimes you'll find such a setting up here in the top menu of the RCP as well. We have auto iris is enabled. So you can see how auto iris will expose the picture slightly differently than I just did manually. We have auto white balance execution, black balance execution down here. We have inactive. Inactive just means that the RCP as a panel is inactivated so that it's it doesn't matter if you touch a knob or whatever. And then the way we classically do it is we use these buttons to change the menu up here. So let's look at what we have there. And some of these things are not available because they are not implemented for this camera or not available on the camera. But one of them is ND filter. So you can see that we can activate the three different filters, 1/4 and 1/16 and 1/64. Or we can turn it off entirely. We have chroma level and contrast as well. If we go to the exposure menu, you can set the shutter mode. Scene files can be selected. And if we go to the white balance mode, you get into the territory, which is so important for a shading operator. So here we have the execution of automatically white balance. But most importantly, you have the gain R, B, and pedestal R and B. So let's take a look at those. Now I am obviously gaining the red channel, and you can see it affects the picture accordingly. I can gain the blue channel as well by turning this knob. If I go to the red pedestal, you can see dramatic changes to the black levels, and the same if I use the blue one here. You can essentially paint the picture as you want with the white balance section of the RCP. If we move on to the image, you have stuff like Nemote and the parameters associated with that. I think in the audio section, you find stuff which is probably relevant on other PDC cameras, although I would say a little bit exotic. And in the user section, it is reserved for whatever you want to put there. So, ladies and gentlemen, this is the RCPv2 working with a UB300 box camera from Panasonic. This is probably the way you want to shade this camera, an RCP that enables this to be a part of a workflow with other broadcast cameras that might also have an RCP from Skaarhoj controlling them. Remember, with our universal panels, you can really mix cameras from many manufacturers but still have a unified user experience in terms of how you shade and adjust the cameras in live broadcast.